Come on, Kim.
Amen. Amen. All the ex-dope smokers say amen.
Do that because it's caused by pressure, optic
relationship passage, sometimes you will hear people say, I've lost my love. I lost my love. Well, you probably haven't lost your love. You've lost your focus.
Come on now.
Some people said, I lost my faith. But it's probably you've lost your focus. Well. And focus is important because Satan caused Eve to sin by losing her focus. Yeah. And the Bible is about us reconnecting with God. Paul said, in him, in a relationship with God through Jesus Christ, we live, we move, we have our very being. In him, in a relationship with him, God through Jesus, we live. When you have a relationship with Jesus, with God, things come alive. Your dreams come alive. Your relationships come alive. Where there's life, there is fruit. Your dream of owning your own business. Your dream of your children going to college and finishing. Your dreams come alive. In him, things live. Even things that you thought were dead and buried. Because he's a resurrecting God.
Yes, sir.
And I'm going to tell somebody in here, you got something that you thought was buried. It was dead. Your dream of maybe having that school, or your dream of going back to school, or maybe you thought your love for a relative or in your marriage was dead. I'm telling you, you have a God where you, when you are in a relationship with him, he can bring dead stuff back to life. We move. Things move. Listen, if things are not moving, you have stagnation. And stagnation is one step from death. I don't drink from stagnant water. I'd rather drink from running water. Something that's moved in him. We live. We move. And we have our very being. You don't know who you are as a man or a woman until you're in a relationship with him. That's why you got folk acting so crazy around here. They don't know who they are. How many years ago, there was one of the young guys here acting like a gangster. Like trying to be like Tupac or Lil Wayne. And I told that boy, I said, boy, you weren't raised like that. You run around here trying to be a gangster and you're 12 years old. What kind of gangster you going to be? But you see, because he was not saved, he didn't know who he was.
Right.
And when you don't know who you are, anybody can tell you anything about yourself. But in him, we live. We move and we know who we are. That's why when you read the Bible, when God would have an encounter with people, the first thing he would tell them, I know what your mama called you, I know what your daddy called you, but let me tell you what I'm going to call you. When he met Simon, he said, I know they call you Simon, but I'm going to call you Petros. You will be a rock.
All right.
When he met Abraham, they called you Abram, which points back that you had a great father. You had a great father, but Abraham means you will be a great father. delivered 3 million people yes. out of bondage.
Yes, sir.
And so he said, seeing that we are surrounded, yes. compassed with examples of so many people who kept their focus and reaped the benefits of keeping their focus, he said, let us run with patience. The race that is set before us, let us keep our focus. But here's the point. He says, fixing and focusing our eyes. King James says looking, but it means fixing and focusing our eyes on Jesus. The author and finisher. That word author, if you read the King James Version, read the New International Version, it says the pioneer. You know what a pioneer is? That's a person who goes to a country before other folk go. He goes to a place where other folk ain't gone.
Yes,
he says what Jesus did, he took focus to a whole nother level that folk had gone before. No matter what happened, Jesus kept his focus. Jesus went through 6 trials where people were paid to lie on him, but he kept his focus. All of his closest of disciples abandoned him, but he kept his focus. One of his closest friends took 30 pieces of silver to have him murdered, but he kept his focus. They spit on him, but he kept his focus. When he was on trial, they took their fist and they hit him in the face, but he kept his focus. They put nails in his hands, but he kept his focus. And he reaped a reward. Because after the devil thought he had won, he came up from the grave. He said, I got all power now. And I'm going to tell you something. When you keep your focus, God will give you power you never dreamed that you had. But you got to keep your focus. So in the book of Genesis, if you go back there, go to Genesis, you'll see how what Satan did, he got Eve to lose her focus. And you see what he did? By the way, let me just say something. I'm going to revert back to something I said last week. And I realize how pathetic it would be. Here's the reason why you cannot lose your focus. And we got young people here. We got some of you kids. And y'all pay attention. I like it. I know sometimes they come in and got their cell phone, you know, out. And that's how kids are. You know, we do that. But let me tell you something. The reason we better keep our focus is because the devil will not lose his focus. In St. John 10 and verse 10, the Bible says he's a thief.
Yes,
and he comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy.
Yes,
to steal, and he does not lose his focus. And I said last week, while we were in worship, I said, I think this service or the first service, I said that some people looked at me funny. I said, I mentioned this, that while we were in worship, the devil and his demons were plotting and scheming to steal, to kill, and destroy. And little did I know that last Sunday about this time, a 19-year-old named Nicholas Cruz was plotting. When he went into that school, he didn't just go into that school and shoot it. He planned that. Now, see, the Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 11 and 2 that the devil has schemes. He has plans. Paul said, you better know the schemes of the devil. The devil is focused. And that boy was focused. And what he did when he went into that school, he knew because he had been in the school and they kicked him out, he knew the days that they would do a fire drill. They had a fire drill early. And then he knew what dismissal was. So he pulled the fire alarm 5 minutes before the dismissal because he knew that those kids, more kids, would be out in the hall. And he could kill them. He had the gas mask on. He knew what rooms to go to. He passed by some people and said, you better get out of the way. He knew it because it was planned. And I'm telling you, I'm telling everybody in here, old folk ought to know, but you young people, I'm going to tell you something. The devil is not playing. He is relentless, he doesn't sleep, he doesn't go on vacation, he has no heart, he has no conscience. He will kill a baby, he will shoot down a 13-year-old or a 16-year-old who's trying to graduate. He does not care. And I'm saying, we better stay focused. eat fruit from the tree that is in the middle of the garden. And you must not touch it, or you will die. Verse 4. You will not certainly die. Obviously, he's contradicting God. For God knows when you eat from it. Now watch. The it is the tree she's not supposed to touch.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Your eyes will be open, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil. Now watch this. But when the woman saw, when she focused and saw that the fruit of that tree, now here's what the devil does. He would try to change your focus from focusing on the things you can have to looking at the things you should not have. And make you focus on, look, she had hundreds of trees, fruit all around. But instead of looking at that which she could have, he got her to focus on the one tree she should not have. And sometimes when we focus on the wrong thing moves, I don't focus. Somebody said, well, preacher, I didn't have a daddy when I was growing up. Yeah, but you had a mama that stepped in and worked two jobs to get you through school. Well, preacher, I didn't have a mama growing up, but you had a daddy who sat for you. Well, preacher, I didn't have a dad or a mama. Well, God gave you a grandmama who sacrificed and took from her Social Security check and her pension to buy clothes for you after she thought she had raised her children already. Well, preacher, I didn't have a dad. Yeah, but you had an uncle, you had a teacher at school, you had a coach. Instead of focusing on what you don't have, you need to thank God for what you do have.
Project
that hurt on a person in the present. For instance, you've been hurt in the past and you meet somebody that texted you.
Thank you.
mama ain't no baby. Pick up your own stuff. It's killing my nerves. I remember years ago when I first started preaching, I was a sister who came and she talked to me. And she was mad at her husband. Here was the deal. She said that every time she was mad at her husband and his mother-in-law. And she was mad because she said, every time his mama called, he'd jump up and he'd go over there, whatever she wants. He got other brothers and sisters. She don't call them, she called him. And every time she called, he jumps up and he goes over there. He does stuff for her. He does it. And I'm just mad. And apparently when they first got married, the mama had kind of said some stuff.
Uh-oh.
And several years had passed, and she was still kind of angry. So I asked a question. I said, let me ask you. I said, how is he? They had some kids, a couple of young kids. How is he with the kids? She said, he's great with kids. He's a good father, good provider. I said, when you guys are together, how is he? She said, we good. When you and I were together, if his mama could call it, we'd be all right. That woman, you know how. I said, okay, let me just share some advice.
Yeah.
I said, number one, stop talking about his mama.
Yes, sir.
We got about two amens on that. Coach. baby daughter. And he loved those kids, and he felt so good to go back to the school that he graduated from. But last Wednesday, when Nicholas Cruz came in there with the AR-15, and Coach Feast was there, as he went down shooting and shooting, he came down close to the room where some kids were, some 14 or 15 year olds. Two girls in particular, because one of them told the story, and as he just shooting, shooting, shooting. When he got ready to shoot there, the coach saw him. And because he was focused on those kids, when he pointed the gun at those two students, jumped in between the shooter and those kids. And the bullets that were meant for them, they went into him. And his wife and his baby daughter, they're going to bury him this week. Focus. Focus. It is a focus we saw in Jesus. Because those nails that were meant for us went into him. The spear that pierced the side that was supposed to be for us went into him.
Yes, sir.
Focus. He was focused on the cross because he loved us. And I want to say to you right now, if you need to get your focus back, you can get it back. We're going to do an invitation song right now. And I invite you to come to me because I need Jesus myself. At this church, we try to get you to Jesus. Because let me tell you, when you put men in a place they should not be, men are let you down. Has anybody ever been let down by somebody? They're let down. Some of us been dropped, kicked off. People will let you down. And just because, and I'm saying, I'm a preacher. And I'm sure I'm sure we'll say the same thing. We are men. That's why I sat up here with a Bible. Study your Bible for yourself.
Yes.
And when you get close to it, you'll find out that we all got issues.
Yes.
And that's why I keep saying that when some of these guys give up somewhere, I don't care what, wherever, and just castigate people and beat people down and send everybody to hell. First of all, I tell folks, you don't have a hell for hell to send anybody to.
Amen.
And if you stay out of hell, it's by the grace of God yourself. Let's call people to Jesus.
Yes,
and love them. And so right now, if you need to get your focus back, it may be that you need Jesus. I got a call this past week. We talked to several people, but in fact, several calls, and I saw the news, and many of us, and I've talked to people that many of us are really, I tell you, it broke so many hearts to see those kids in Florida at a school, which, by the way, they just said last week was considered one of the safest schools in the country. But what they found, what we all know, safety is not in a place. It's in a relationship with Jesus. And even then, that doesn't mean that bad things won't happen, because bad things happen to good people.
Yes,
but even if the God comes, even if death comes, Jesus will take care of his children.
Amen.
Even if it means going into eternity. But I am saying that we must get focused back on Jesus and make sure that we stay close to him. And that shook all of us up, and we're concerned about our children. And I'm going to do a prayer, a special prayer today for our children. And in a minute, just in a moment, when we sing that call, right now in a special way. You have a special concern for these kids. When we do an altar call, there's nothing wrong with coming up. And let's just pray together with one heart. The churches are doing this all over Houston. We've got great churches all over Houston that are praying. And let's just stand with them. And let's just pray. Let's pray. And that's the anointing of the Holy Spirit to just move and cover some of these schools and some of these places. Our administrators, we dump on our teachers. They got to be teacher and counselor and mama and dad and grandmama and nurse. We're dumping so much on our educators. We're dumping on them. They're underpaid. They're overworked. They give out of their own pocket. And sometimes to a community that does not even appreciate them.
Amen.
We send broken children to people that I believe, quite frankly, many times are treated like dirt. And we need to pray for them. Bad coach. And the other two adults that died, they died the same way trying to save those kids. Bad coach represents who's in our schools. And I know you got some that shouldn't be there, you got some that shouldn't be there, but the most of them, they would give their lives for our children. And that's perfect. Spirit. We got to get hit by the Holy Spirit. Look at those babies.